Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Cicada Club. Tonight, the Duma Television Network presents tonight at the Cicada Club, broadcast live across the nation and around the world by means of electronic television. Presenting a torrent of top talent and tunes directly into your home from Maxwell DeMille's Cicada Club in lovely downtown Los Angeles, California. Tonight, it's Maxwell DeMille's annual 39th birthday party with an annual tradition since liquor was illegal. Starring Dean Mora and his orchestra. Yours truly, Conrad Montebank. Plus a plethora of special guest stars. Now, ladies and gentlemen, all aboard the Cicada Club Streamliner, barreling towards you, leaving Hollywood at the speed of sound. And behind the throttle, your master of ceremonies, Mr. Maxwell DeMille.
Thank you, Conrad Montebank.
Thank you, Maxwell DeMille.
And thank you, Dean Mora and your orchestra.
You're very welcome, Maxwell DeMille.
All right, let's not get started right away. I'm trying to have a nice time here, and already they're starting. Say, Conrad, you get shorter every week.
Well, Maxwell, you're getting larger.
Well, let's not go in that direction, ladies and gentlemen, because I'd like to find out where you were last week. We had a special guest announcer, ladies and gentlemen. The delightful Johnny Holiday was our guest announcer last week.
Johnny Holiday, the handsomest man in the world?
So he says.
Yes, Maxwell DeMille, my radio duties took me to downtown Hollywood to fake radio, where we performed a Richard Diamond, the singing detective mystery.
And what part did you play?
I played Maxwell Diamond, the singing detective.
Maxwell Diamond!
I really played Richard Diamond, but it's fun to say Maxwell.
If you say so. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to open the dance floor for you for your dancing pleasure. We have a swell show in store for you tonight. Lots of surprises, lots of guests, as I celebrate once again my annual 39th birthday party.
Hey!
So now, ladies and gentlemen, no, please, please, please. The dance floor is open. Here they are. Music by Mora.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dean Mora. You're listening to my orchestra. How about it, folks? They sound swell tonight. We're here to celebrate Mr. DeMille's 3900th anniversary. The 39th anniversary of the from the date that he said he was 39, or something like that. Anyway, that was a great Harry James, The Mole. We're going to continue now with another great band leader, Charlie Barnett, playing for you this tune called The Pompton Turnpike. Our featured soloists on the alto saxophone, Jeff Newdell. And on the screaming trumpet back there, Jim Ziegler. Great Charlie Barnett and Pompton Turnpike. He was a fellow, if those of you who know the history of the famed Palomar Ballroom that started the whole swing craze in 1935 with Benny Goodman, it was in 1939 with Charlie Barnett that it burned to the ground. Yes, yes, very sad. And now it's some warehouse there on the corner of Vermont and 2nd. Very sad. Oh, speaking of sad, Mr. DeMille.
Thank you, Dean Mora. Say, Dean, how old are you turning this year?
I'm not throwing a birthday party, if you may have noticed.
Yes. Say, folks, I'd just like to let everybody know we're broadcasting live across the nation and around the world by means of electronic television. Our cameras are trained on the dance floor, so if you don't want to be noticed, hide in the shadows.
I want to be noticed.
I know you do. Ladies and gentlemen, Conrad Montebank. Yes, here, listen to that applause. Now we know.
All three of them. It's
yes, thank you. Yes, we are. Thousands of folks are watching us around the world by means of electronic television. We'd like to say hello to our listening and watching audience. Well, thank you. And now, let's have some more music by Dean Mora and his orchestra.
Hooray!
Thank you, Conrad. Thank you, Maxwell.
It's my pleasure.
No, it's my pleasure.
Come on, get off the stand.
And also mine.
Come on, beat it. Scram. And now we turn to the book of the great Benny Carter, his 1943 rendition of Love for Sale. On Barry Sax, Chris Tedesco on a high G.
Very nice. That's all he got. That's all he has for tonight. That's it. Good night. All right.
And what better to follow a screaming note than a redhead? Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome. Take it easy, fella. Take it easy. Take it easy. Our lovely canary of song. Our marvelous melodeer from Michigan, Kara Morrison. Ooh, very good. I like that one. Gonna sing for you a tune. This was arranged by our dear friend, the great, late, great Spud Murphy. Blame It on My Last Affair.
I walk and I'm called, and I don't turn like that. Should I be introduced, and I sound very flat. It isn't a grudge I bear, blame it on my last affair. If I pass up my plate, though the dish is delish, if I'm handed the bone, and I don't care to wish, it isn't the bill of fare. Blame it on my last affair. It hurt me so, and now I don't know if I'll ever live it through. There's no excuse for this abuse coming from one like you. If my eyes fill with tears, at least love word said. If I walk in the park when I should be in bed, it's not that I need the air. Blame it on my last affair.
Blame it on my last affair. You want to hear another song by Care? I'm sorry. Hello, hello, hello. You want to hear another song by Care Morrison? We'll blame the sound man, as we usually do on that one. Just kidding. You're doing a fine job, by the way. We're going to have Care sing a tune that was popularized by the Andrews Sisters way back in 1949. This talks about the fakery that we all know and love as Hollywood. And it's a tune called He Rides the Range.
While escaping from a posse of men,
His director's always jumping up and shouting, cut! We'll have to shoot it over again. He rides the range for Republic, where the western breezes blow. He rides the range for Republic.
For Republic Studios. All right, so this is a two-parter, you recall. At the end of part one, you guys hold the note. Okay, I guess we're in the page, we're in, right? No? Okay, I'm going to have you guys hold that note until we got to meet with the next customer. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do an Artie Shaw number for you. It's one of his great recordings that he did on two sides of a 78 record because it was quite long. It's his take on the great song St. James Infirmary. We're going to have our own trumpet player, Mr. Both Parts, yes, Both Parts. Jim Ziegler is going to sing for you and play, and you're going to like it and fill up that dance floor. St. James Infirmary.
Lord knows that she was a good girl. and I know we'll meet again off there. Now when I die, want you to dress me in straight-laced shoes, black suit and a Stetson hat. $100 won't be on my watches, so the fellows will know I died standing high.
Turning the record, Albert.
It's your old pal Conrad Montebank here to tell you about next Sunday at the Cicada Club. It's the Rhythm Club All-Stars Night of the Divas, featuring Wendy Ray, Jennifer Keith, and Christine Nelson. And now, back to Dean Mora and his orchestra. But first, a word from Mr. Maxwell DeMille.
Thank you, Conrad Montebank.
It's my pleasure, sir.
It certainly is. Say, folks, I'd just like to let you know we do have some of our special guests in the audience tonight. They will be coming up to the stage and performing for you in just a little bit, including Jennifer Keith and Christine Nelson.
Well.
We'll be here next week, along with Mr. Daniel Klass, drummer extraordinaire, with
and
the Rhythm Club All-Star.
And quite the diva.
He is indeed. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to ask some of you folks on the dance floor to step back a ways. We have a special number for you. Say, folks, now you two folks standing right in front of that table, if you could just move to the side. Thank you very much. She's tops in taps. Let's hear it, ladies and gentlemen. The one, the only, Rusty Frank.
Rusty Frank.
She's tops and taps, Rusty Frank. And say, folks, Rusty's got her own fabulous club on Wednesday nights. It's the Rhythm Club. So please visit Rusty Frank, and she'll tell you all about her delightful club, which happens to be no competition to us because we're on Sunday night. For each and every Sunday, we bring in this wonderful broadcast. And now, here's Dean Mora lurking in the shadows. What have you got in store for us now, Mr. Mora?
Well, we're going to do a number featuring Damon Kirsch, a lovely number called How Are Things in Glacamora?
Yes, the condor of croon himself, ladies and gentlemen.
A dashing dude from the Dakotas.
Let's hear it for Damon Kirsch and Dean Mora and his orchestra.
And once again, folks, as the band gets to their places in the music, I just want to remind you to don't forget to buy Maxwell a drink because it is his birthday. I suppose there's going to be a contest as you guess which 39th birthday it is, a contest in which there is no winner. And now, here we are with How Are Things in Glacamora. The dance floor is open.
Thank you. sings in Glockamora. Is that little brook still leaping there? Does it still run down through Donegal, through Killybegs, Kilkerry and Kildare? How are things in Glockamora? Is that willow tree still weeping there? Does the lassie with the twinkling eye come smiling by? And does she walk away sad and dreamy there, not to see me there? So I ask each weeping willow and each brook along the way, and each lass who comes a sighing to run away. How are things in Glockamora this fine day?
Once again, the dashing dude from the Dakotas, Damon Kirsch. How about a big hand for Damon, folks? We'll be back later on in the evening. He'll be back later on in the evening. Oh, I sound much taller on this one. Here's a modern treatment of an old familiar song from 1927, I'm Coming, Virginia. Updated for modern audiences such as yourself.
Thank you.
I'm coming, Virginia. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. As promised, we're going to bring back Damon Kirsch and sing for you a number of, from one of the most beautiful melodies in the big band era. And this is a theme song from a motion picture by David Raxon from 1945. This is Laura. How many people here are named Laura tonight? Everybody's named Laura. The guys are named Laura. Oh, hello, Laura. Hello, Mr. Laura. Nice to meet you. Anyway, here we go. David Raxon and Laura.
That is
Pierce singing for you, Laura. Dedicated to all the Lauras in the world.
And say, folks, you know, we have a bit of a film noir theme going tonight. And what could be better than the music from the movie Laura, composed by the late, great David Raxon?
That's correct, sir. And I see a lot of folks there in your noir finery.
We have a few femme fatales in the house, ladies and gentlemen, as well as a few mugs and a few saps.
Plenty of saps, I'll tell you that.
Well, that's typical things you'd find in a film noir. Say, what other types of noirish music have you in store for us, Mr. Mora?
Well, funny you should ask right now, because we're going to do one that is one of the quintessential tunes. Perhaps not realized during that era, but we sort of made it that way as the years went along. It's by Earl Hagen from 1940, Harlem Nocturne.
That's a swell tune, I'll say.
We're going to feature Jeff Newdell on the mournful alto sax.
You mean the world-famous Jeff Newdell?
The very same.
King of the licorice stick?
Perhaps so, yes.
I'll say.
Thank you, Mr. DeMille. And don't forget, his 39th birthday. So buy him a drink. Buy him a drink. Buy plenty.
Thank you.
honor to have these guys playing behind me, and I'm just waving my arms. Without them, I'd just be a guy waving my arms. But thank you all very much. We have one more number for this set. And stick around. We have some great guest artists showing up during this break. Mr. DeMille will be telling you more about that later. So let's finish off with a rousing bugle call rag.
Ladies and gentlemen. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is Conrad Montebank, here to say hello to all of our friends watching us around the world by means of electronic television. And to remind you, the next Sunday, Maxwell DeMille Cicada Club proudly presents the Rhythm Club All-Stars Night of the Divas, featuring Wendy Ray, Jennifer Keith, and Christine Nelson. And now, here to tell you more is Mr. Maxwell DeMille!
Say, folks, let's hear it for the hardest working man here tonight, me, Maxwell DeMille! Thank you. As I celebrate my delightful annual 39th birthday party, ladies and gentlemen, we have some special guests in the house that are going to come up now and do a few numbers for you. So why don't we bring them up, shall we?
We shall.
Shall we?
Let's.
Well, look who it is. It's Richard Halpern.
Richard Halpern?
Who each and every month has his delightful Roaring Twenties review. Say, Richard, you want to use this microphone?
Which one? This
now,
one here?
Yes. Now, of course, we don't know what you're going to do, Mr. Dean Mora.
What do you think of Dean Mora and his amazing orchestra? Maestro Dean Mora. And the lovely Care Morrison with her furs that she brought in tonight. And Damon Kirsch, where is Damon?
The Condor of Croon.
The Condor of Croon, yes. Well, I guess we could sing a song if you'd like to hear something. Any requests out there? What do you want to hear, table number two? Pick something that you all like. John Reynolds, what do you think I should sing, John Reynolds? Liza. Do we know Liza? Or do we not know Liza? Now pick another one then.
Pick something
no
from
words to Soul Bossa Nova. I'm sorry.
Tin Pan Alley era. Maybe some Jolson. Any Jolson fans in the house? Here we go. Mr. Richard Halpern.
Blue skies smiling at me, nothing but blue skies do I see. Blue birds singing a song, nothing but blue birds all day long. Never saw the sun shining so bright, never saw things going so right. Noticing the days hurrying by, when you're in love, oh, do they fly. Blue days, 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 all of them gone, nothing but blue skies from now on. That's right. That's his blue. Here's couple number one on the dance floor. Little bluebirds all day long. Yeah. Look at this. Oh, there's Lauren Brodian on the dance floor. Hello. Blue skies smiling at me. Oh, nothing but little blue skies do I see. Bluebirds, they're singing a song. Nothing but bluebirds all day long. I never saw the sun shining so bright. I never saw things going so right. Noticing the days hurrying by. When you're in love, oh, do they fly. Blue days, days, all of them gone. Nothing but blue skies from now on.
Thank you, folks.
You Richard Halpern.
Thank you, Maxwell DeMille. And look at this. It's a lovely chocolate cigar that I bought from the lovely Miss Lola.
Miss Lola, our cigarette girl, lurking around the Cicada Club somewhere.
She was right there. She's gone now. She's hiding. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dean Mora. Thank you very much. And we will see you all back here on August the 30th for Richard Halpern's Roaring Twenties Review.
Thank you, Richard Halpern.
Thank you, Maxwell. Happy birthday.
Thank you. And say, folks, the guests just keep coming and coming. It's time to bring another delightful guest to the microphone. She's going to be here with her high society boys. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause for that lovely Hollywood songbird, Jennifer Keefe.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Maxwell DeMille. And ladies and gentlemen, I would like to take a moment to, of course, thank Mr. Dean Mora and the wonderful orchestra. Don't they sound wonderful? And of course, this next song that I've chosen, I chose this specifically for our birthday boy because I consider him a man of mystery. I don't know about you, but this is for you. Happy birthday, Mr. DeMille. I know a little bit about a lot of things, but I don't know enough about you. Just when I think you're mine, you try a different line. And baby, what can I do? I read the latest news, no buttons on my shoes. But baby, I'm confused about you. You've got me in a spin. Oh, what a stew I'm in. 'Cause I don't know enough about you. Jack of all trades, master of none. And isn't it a shame? I'm so sure that you'd be good for me if you only play my game. You know I went to school, and I'm nobody's fool. That is to say, until I met you. I know a little bit about a lot of things, but I don't know enough about you. You know I went to school, and I'm nobody's fool. That is to say, until I met you, I know a little bit about a lot of things, but I don't know enough about you. I know a bit about biology and a little more about psychology. I'm a little gem in geology, but I don't know enough about you. No, I don't know enough about you. No, I don't know enough about you.
Thank you very much. Happy birthday, Mr. DeMille.
Thank you, Jennifer Keith. Oh, dear. And of course, we'll see Jennifer Keith and the High Society Boys in just 2 weeks. August 9th. And now it's time to bring yet another sultry songbird to the microphone. She'll be here with her Macombo Moderns August 16th. Ladies and gentlemen, the always effervescent Christine Nelson.
Every honeybee fills with jealousy when they see you out with me. I don't blame them, goodness knows. Honeysuckle Rose. When you're passing by, flowers droop and sigh, and I know the reason why. You're much sweeter, goodness knows. Honeysuckle Rose. Don't buy sugar, you just have to touch my cup. You're my sugar, it's sweet when you stir it up. When I'm taking sips from your tasty lips, seems the honey barely drips. Your confection, goodness knows, honeysuckle rose.
Thank you. Happy birthday, Mr. DeMille. Let's hear it for the gorgeous Dean Mora on the keys.
Thank you, the lovely, the effervescent Christine Nelson. And we'll see you with your Macombo Moderns on the 16th of August. And now it's time to bring to the microphone a very popular attraction here at the Cicada Club. You all know her as the Boop-a-Doop Girl. Here she is, the delightful Ginger Polly.
Thank you. This one, okay.
There you are. That's your very own microphone.
This is fine. Thanks.
Thank you.
This is for you, Mr. DeMille. Love, 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 love. Look what you've done to me. I just had a kid for Clara Bow, but he likes Clara Bow, and that's my weakness now. Oh my, oh me. Oh, I should be good, and I would be good, but gee. He likes to run the show. I never cared to run the show, but he likes to run the show, and that's my weakness now. He likes a saxophone. I never cared for a saxophone, but he likes a saxophone, and that's my weakness now. He likes those rainy days. I never cared for a rainy day, but he likes a rainy day, and that's my weakness now. Oh, let it rain, let it pour, 'cause I think he knows just what it's raining for. He likes a long good night. I never had a long good night, but he likes a long good night, and that's my weakness now. He likes boop-boop-dee-doo. I never cared for boop-boop-dee-doo, but he likes boop-boop-dee-doo, and that's my weakness now. And he likes button-da-ba-da-ba-da. I never cared for button-da-ba-da-ba-da, but he likes ba-da-da-da, and that's my weakness now. What more? What more? Well, I think he knows what pa-pa-pa is for. He likes boop-boop-dee-doo. I never cared for boop-boop-dee-doo, but he likes boop-boop-dee-doo, and that's my weakness now. And that's my weakness now. Happy birthday, Mr. DeMille.
Thank you, Ginger Polly. Oh, please. Ginger Polly, and of course she'll be here at the Cicada Club with her Hoosier Daddies. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to bring a boy to the microphone who's grown into a real man. He's performed here several times at the Cicada Club, yet we have him back anyway. Ladies and gentlemen, Bing's favorite nephew, here he is, the one, the only, Mr. Johnny Holiday.
Good evening and a very happy birthday to Maxwell DeMille. Ladies and gentlemen, in honor of Mr. DeMille's birthday, Dean Mora, who, by the way, and his orchestra have done such a marvelous job tonight, don't you think? I've got Dean on retainer. I can't go anywhere now. Folks, I want to sing a song for Mr. DeMille. It's a tune I know that he enjoys. It was recorded in March of 1931 by my uncle. It was the biggest hit record. It was his first solo effort on the Brunswick label. It's entitled Out of Nowhere. Damon can go home now.
You came to me from out of nowhere. You took my heart and found it free. Wonderful dreams, wonderful schemes from nowhere, making each hour sweet as a flower for me. If you should go back to your nowhere, leaving me with a memory, I'll always wait for your return out of nowhere, hoping you'll bring your love to me.
Mr. Dean Mora, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, you should go back to your nowhere, leaving me with a memory. I'll always wait for your return out of nowhere, hoping you'll bring your love to me.
Ladies and gentlemen, before Mr. DeMille, thank you very much. Dean, we're gonna do one chorus of a song where the lyrics have been written exactly for Mr. DeMille. I hope you'll humor us. We'll do it, just one chorus. I wanna tell you folks, here in this lovely room, DeMille is 96, so they say. My friends at Forest Lawn, who prepped me for this show, prepped Mr. DeMille earlier today. He used to entertain the troops at camp shows. Lincoln praised his efforts, as we all know, so keep on buying Lux, 'cause Johnny needs the bucks. Happy birthday, Mr. D.
Johnny Holiday. Thank you, Johnny Holiday. Now it's time to bring to the microphone a very special surprise guest, ladies and gentlemen. I had a question, a scientific question. I'd like to bring this gentleman up. Perhaps you could answer. How about a big round of applause for Mr. Bill Nye, the scientific fellow.
Mr. DeMille.
Yes, I know it's Bill Nye, the scientific guy, but here at the Cicada Club, he's a scientific fellow.
How charming, how not mellow.
Yes, could you briefly explain to me, is light a particle or a wave? I can't decide.
No one can. You know, 94% of the universe, we really don't know what it is. But when I'm here, at least I feel part of that 6%. Happy birthday, Mr. DeMille. Happy orbit of the sun.
Thank you so much. And I always like to celebrate this time of year, as we've just passed the solstice, and now we're heading toward the...
equinox?
Armistice.
Would but that we were. Happy orbit of the sun.
Thank you very much.
Happy orbit of the sun to you.
And happy orbit of the moon and mooning for you, Bill Nye, the science guy.
Thank you. Carry on.
Now, of course, we've arranged at great expense, ladies and gentlemen. We've procured him from the 24th century. You've seen him in various guises. He's been all the way through the Stargate. And he's made a trek to the stars, ladies and gentlemen. The one, the only, Robert Picardo.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I do hate to follow my friend Bill Nye and my friend Johnny Holiday, but I'm only reading tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Maxwell's dear friend, Cole Porter, desperately wanted to be here tonight. But unfortunately, a prior commitment, death, prevented that. But he did send this note, and I'd like to share it with you right now. The night is young, the sky is clear, we're celebrating a birthday here. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's DeMille Day. Today he turned 39, and like Jack Benny, it's the umpteenth time. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's DeMille Day. You can tell at a glance, it's been 10 years since he bought new pants, vintage shirts, ties, and shoes. He loves, we've been told, he smells just like mold. So raise a glass to toast this gent, and pass the hat till we've paid his rent. He's decrepit, not deceased, not yet. It's DeMille Day. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this celebration of your friend and mine, Maxwell DeMille. Yes, I'll never forget the day
I'll never forget the day that I first met Mr. DeMille. We were both auditioning to be the before picture in the Hair Club for Men ad. Sorry, that's the only joke I wrote, and I have to make it to the bridge. Are we ready? With a name like DeMille, you're a surefire show business shill, not a meek tinker, tailor, doctor, or chef like Stanley or Jeff. A Lothario impresario who's never been to the barrio. He's delightful, he's delirious, takes Viagra when he's serious. Catch you later at Cicada for a toast to Max. It's the Mill Day. Thank you very much.
Robert Picardo. Say, Mr. Picardo, how much will it cost me to buy back my introduction to you? And now we have one more very special person to come up to the microphone, and I've brought her out of the past to perform for you to sing a very special song. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the late, great Marilyn Monroe.
Oh. Oh. Wow. Hi, everybody. So, Mr. DeMille, I understand it's your birthday. Well, I worked up a little something for you, so may I? Here, come very close. There we go. Let me see if I remember how this goes. Oh, yes. Happy birthday to you. Oh, it's a nice shape. Happy birthday to you. This would be the part where I run my fingers through your hair. To you. Oh, it's nice and soft. Happy birthday. Are you a president?
I'm a precedent.
Oh, yes, you are. Happy birthday, Mr. Unprecedented DeMille. Oh, you're a mouthful. If I do say so myself. Where was I? Oh, happy. Happy. Happy birthday to you.
The late, great Marilyn Monroe. Thank you. Well, wasn't that something, ladies and gentlemen? You know, you don't turn 39 every day, just every year. And now we'll give Mr. Poor Dean Mora a chance to rest his weary fingers. Of course, you can head back. What's that? Where's the rest of the band? They're in the bar where they normally hang out. Because the more they drink, the better they sound. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll put on some recorded music for your dancing pleasure, and then we'll be back with another set of Dean Mora and his orchestra, plus more surprise performers. Thank you, Dean. Thank you, everyone.
sky smiling at me. Nothing but blue sky. Do I see?